Boy, there's nothing like rainfall Mother Nature gets all the corners. But when we're irrigating during the summer, we're looking for an average of an inch of water a week, but we'll go more like a half inch twice a week, and it all depends on the situation as far as what stage we are. At harvest time, we're definitely going to be going, maybe a third of an inch three times a week. And we'll water at different times of year. At harvest time, we're going to water very early in the morning. The plants are already wet, so you're not adding any extra moisture to the canopy for disease pressure and things like that. However, before harvest and after harvest, we would water in the evening so we get more bang for our buck with less evaporation and more soak-in time during the evening. Well, the irrigation system we use on our farm is the standard solid set aluminum pipe risers and impact sprinklers. And to tell you the truth, on our farm, where our location is, we usually get adequate moisture. Very, very rarely do we have more than a couple of weeks without rainfall, so our irrigation is pretty much supplemental and touching up maybe where Mother Nature was a little slight or something like that. But this fall we had a stretch of maybe 4 or 5 weeks without adequate rainfall, and we're using our system, which is laterals of irrigation every 60 feet and 30 or 40 feet between sprinklers, and usually does a great job. For frost control, we use our irrigation system to supply a thin film of water over the plants, especially the strawberry buds themselves. And as long as I keep a thin film of water that hasn't frozen, the flower bud can't be below 32 degrees. This year we were very lucky. We only had one frost event, but it started earlier than we anticipated. And I just came out at 10 o'clock at night to check the temps, to kind of get everything calibrated to my home thermometer, because I'm about 5 or 10 minutes away by car. And when I got out to the field, it was already like 34 degrees. So I had to get going and start pumping water right away. And we started about 10:30 at night and went till 6:30 in the morning. Something to think about when people are planning an irrigation system, and especially for frost controls, we are surface water pumping, but we fill our surface water with groundwater. We're filling a holding pond at 300 gallons a minute. We're taking water out for frost protection anywhere from 12 to 2,000 gallons a minute. So there's a lot of pre-planning. So your holding pond has got to be as big enough, we feel, to handle 3 nights of frost protection. I've never done more than 3 nights, and I know with Mother Nature is always throwing curveballs at you, but and very rarely for us to do more than two. Very rare for us to do under two in a row, because my father always used to say the second night's the colder one. And gosh darn it, if that isn't almost true every time.